What is the area of this trapezoid? Not all quadrilaterals come in cute, easy-to-solve shapes. The trapezoid helps us out in some of those situations. The trapezoid is the oddball of the quadrilateral family. It looks like a rectangle and a triangle or two fused together. The regular, or isosceles trapezoid, has one pair of parallel sides, also known as the bases, and a set of congruent legs. The base angles are congruent, and so are the top angles. The irregular trapezoid also has one pair of parallel sides, but the legs aren't congruent. The base angles aren't congruent. And in the case of right trapezoids, a pair of consecutive angles will both be right. A trapezoid looks like a rectangle that has had a triangle or two attached to it, right? So theoretically, we could just find the area by combining the formula for the area of a rectangle, area equals base times height, with the formula for the area of a triangle, area equals one-half the base times the height. But because the number of triangles is inconsistent across trapezoids, we'd have to figure out how many triangles to add on for every trapezoid, which sounds like more work than is necessary. It turns out that math, great modeling system that it is, has a single simple formula that will give us the area of any trapezoid. Area equals the sum of base 1 and base 2 multiplied by the height, then divided by 2. If I had worked out how we actually derived this formula, it would have given us this formula: A equals one-half the height times the sum of base 1 and base 2. But it's been my experience that this version of the formula doesn't consistently give you the right answer, so stick with the first one. Plug in the measures you do have from the trapezoid and solve for the one you don't. Now, let's find the area of our trapezoid. We know the bases have lengths of 2 units and 6 units, and that the trapezoid is 5 units high. When we plug everything in and work it out, we find that this trapezoid has an area of 20 units squared. To find the area of a trapezoid, add the bases together and multiply the sum by the height, then divide that number by 2.